Top down, and there's little flexibility for Warriors and Cavaliers to change the way they do things, but we want to support a lot of local innovation and even scale out that innovation. First, there were some suggestions that in terms of working at local level, perhaps we could bypass in a way the government planning system by working directly with farmers or with NGOs, but it was pointed out that pretty much any activity that's going to take place, even if it comes with external resources, has to be approved by the Warriors. So we may have no choice except to kind of work within that plan to an extent, work with their system, but you know, learning from other NGOs that there may be opportunities to work within that but add some new elements, and if you can then demonstrate that those are effective, then perhaps you can advocate for more scaling out next year or in the future. So some constraints at local level. In terms of engaging with actually changing that planning process, clearly we need to do some good analysis of where exactly decisions are made and how planning works, including going to higher levels than Warriors and Cavaliers and find out who to engage. It was suggested that at regional level, a good organisation to perhaps broker with regional government could be quasi-governmental organisations who may have a role in setting some of the quotas at regional level and would probably have the ear of regional government and could also be people to pilot and demonstrate new approaches. It was suggested we could also work with regional agricultural research organisations, although these may not always have the mandate to talk about water issues, so we have to be aware of those sectoral divides as well. The second question, we only put on to two of the three, was about how to deal with the fact that the situations in our sites are rapidly changing. It was pointed out that a lot of changes shouldn't be unpredictable because we can look at Warrior medium-term development plans, which should tell us what infrastructure development is likely to happen. Also, there are river basin development plans, so we should be aware of those. Of course, some changes are less predictable, perhaps market changes and so on. So we need to, you know, we can't stop situations changing, it's always going to be evolving. We need to monitor the changes as best we can, support people to be able to manage change and deal with change and even capitalise on it, perhaps involving people like market entrepreneurs who can look for the new opportunities that changes may create. And perhaps in developing our strategies, we need to not just come with one strategy, but develop some kind of exploratory different scenarios and look at, you know, different trajectories that the Warriors could take and then think, okay, what strategy is going to be robust in all those different future scenarios, and make sure that we build that kind of future thinking in from the start.